Hello everyone, back again doing some more Yu-Gi-Oh! Link Evolution gameplay here. So, I looked at a few decks and kind of was looking to see what I wanted to use and play against. Let's play against these guys. Try some True Dracos. Broken True Dracos with the three demise, three diagram. Because you don't really have to play by the ban list, so pretty simple to beat the game through. I mean, I'm going to be eating here, because, you know, a little bit of time you get a day to eat. Alright, so set, activate, summon. I want to keep the return as opposed to drawing a card. I think I forgot to activate the effect to get the extra summon. Yeah, I think that's how that would have been worded. But that would have been bounced back anyway, so it didn't matter. Flipping the anti-spell. Oh, you're gonna have to keep asking me this.
Your kids are heavy sleepers. Carry them into their sibling's bed. Carry them into their sibling's bed and let them wake up in a different room to start April Fools on the right foot. Now, that's actually called trauma-based form of fun. That's trauma right there. Okay, first of all, removing your child from the room could be pretty traumatic because it could be an abductor, especially in today's world with how they're training people to be completely out of control, you know, unhinged and psychotic. Also, you know, when your child wakes up in a different place, that's probably traumatic. So I'm going to have to, again, say don't do that. Number three, juice joke. This is really sick, by the way. This is from the Today Show. If I did a video like this, I mean, this would be considered some type of criminal thing, right? Anyway, juice joke. Care for a drink? When your family tries taking a sip of this juice, they'll find out it's really Jell-O. And they put a picture of Jell-O in a cup. I don't even think I'm going to remember to reuse it. That was pretty lame. This sounds gross. Number four, I'm not even going to remember the numbers here. All right. Underwear surprise. Here's another one. Swap out the contents of their underwear drawer for bathing suits for an early morning prank that'll get all the laughs. Would you really laugh if you woke up, you know, next to me, or I woke up next to you, or you woke up next to your husband, or whomever, and you opened the underwear drawer at 7 in the morning and your underwear wasn't in there, and what was in there was your bathing suit, would you really laugh, or would you just be like, oh, right? I mean, that is pretty corny. Okay, next one up. It's called I See You, like as an all-seeing eye. It says, give your kids a laugh by attaching googly eyes to everything. Well, that sounds like a dork sense of humor here. Next up, balloon closet or drawer. I'm sure they would pick red balloons too, by the way. Fill your child's closet or dresser drawers with balloons.
That's not exactly what I was trying to do.
When they wake up for school and look for an outfit, they'll be in for a colorful surprise, right? All red balloons. Next up, toilet paper
came in defense.
Message. Right, April Fools in the toilet paper.
Oh my gosh.
Unfold the toilet paper and leave a funny message for the unsuspecting user. I'm laughing because I was thinking of a joke. But one option, you're going to wash your hands, right? Scribble a note. I was thinking more of the lines of like, surprise, an exclamation point. You've got graphene oxide in you. It's something like that. It would be pretty funny to me, at least. But also sick, I guess, right? So anyway, next up. Honk for April Fool's. So, yeah, let's start some road rage, right? Let your practical jokers put a sign on your car that reads, my kids are playing an April Fool's joke on me. Honk and wave at me. This joke is even funnier if they get to take a ride in the car with you. Some of this stuff is so lame, I don't even know what to say. Next up, this is Today Show, folks. Again, all these people are organically famous. But, by the way, I mean, if you know anybody who thinks these people are funny, these people like Stephen Colbert, the Today Show people, I mean, you want to talk about manufactured human. These people couldn't even be bigger dorks. switcheroo. But again, by design. I'm sure these people in real life are really psychotically sick, but they act like that way, you know, that way on TV because that's how they formulate behavior. Oh, right, I forgot what channel I'm on. Formulate behavior. Anyway, toothpaste switcheroo. Surprise your kids this April Fool's with a little toothpaste switch. After breakfast, hand over their toothbrush, but instead of the usual white paste, opt for something creamy and sweet. Cream cheese or vanilla frosting will do the trick. If they use a color kids' tooth gel, try using cake decorated gel instead. A little too much time going to that. Here's another sick one. Bugs in your juice. Well, how is that even an April Fool's prank? I put bugs in my juice. I eat bugs. So why is that a bad thing? That's very judgmental. But this says it's an oldie and a goodie. This prank's very easy to make at home with this tip. Add almost boiling water to the ice cube trays and toss in a few plastic bugs. The hotter the water, the more clear the ice will be when frozen. Next up, sweet trick. Offer up brownies as an afternoon snack, but everyone will be shocked when they find brown letter E's. Get it? Brown E's instead. That was real funny. Milk shenanigans. Add a few drops of food coloring to the carton of milk. When your child goes to pour it into her glass or bowl or cereal, she'll get a colorful surprise. Bright pink or blue or green milk. I got a good one of my own. Find the closest neighbor that has a flag up that's blue and yellow from another country and get a dozen eggs. April Fools came early. Mr. Dykey early. No? All right. Anyway, bath time hoax. Using a Q-tip, apply gel food coloring around the inside of the faucet in the bathtub or sink. When the faucet is turned on, you're left with colored water. Okay? Pillow prank. Just when they thought April Fool's Day was over, here's one last prank. Remove the pillows and fill their pillowcases with several partially inflated balloons. That sounds like it could be traumatic when it pops in your ear and makes you deaf or somebody has PTSD and they got a real problem. But when they put their head down to sleep, they realize they're on a balloon and you get the last laugh. April Fools, I've caused you more trauma. Next up, cupcakes for dinner. Your kids will think you're the coolest mom ever. For a moment, at least. But bake up mini meatloafs and muffin cups. Don't forget the colorful wrappers. Then frost them with creamy mashed potatoes. See how long it takes your kids to realize that you really aren't that cool after all. And that's, of course, if you have 17 free hours a day to make meatloaf muffins covered in mashed potatoes. Sounds like a lot of work for a joke that no one's going to end up eating. Next up, whoopee cushion. Of course, the old whoopee cushion. We'll just skip through the explanation of it. Salty hot chocolate. This also sounds a bit abusive. Instead of adding sugar to the drink, add salt. I guess it's better than adding Ex-Lax. Your kids may be excited for the first sip of the warm, sweet drink. But that first sip will surprise them. Yep, so just give them a little bit more sodium, because they don't have enough already in every single food that's manufactured. So dump a little sodium in their hot cocoa. They won't even know the difference, because they're so used to getting stuffed with it. That's why most people are so blown up. But anyway, you know, that, of course, is high fructose corn syrup. But don't eat meat, folks. Don't eat meat. Next up, alarm clock fast forward. Yeah, until Johnny gets laid off from his job, because he comes in an hour late. But anyway, oh, right, this society. You're allowed to come in a few hours late. Only if you're a certain skin color or a certain gender, of course. You know. Anyway, we all want as much sleep as the next person before work or class. Push the time on your kid's clock a couple hours forward and watch your kid's reaction when they realize they're ready for their 9 a.m. class at 7. Oh, okay. So why don't you just cause some drama, you know, make him exhausted so he can't pay attention to class. I mean, some of these are, you know, I mean, it's not sick, but like, you know. If you were living with that person and they did it to you, like, would you probably stop? I mean, I can't even say that because that's assault now, so I won't even say. Anyway, a bedtime classic. Borrow a summer camp classic and short sheet your kid's bed before bedtime. When they try to get in, you'll have the last laugh. That's really bad. Fake cake pop. This sweet treat is hiding a savory scent. The sad about it is somebody's probably making like 70, 80 grand. Maybe even 100 at the Today Show writing this. Okay? Now, this was, I guess, aired on TV, too. But I'm reading you from the article. So, yeah. Anyway. Okay, fake cake pop. This sweet treat is hiding a savory center. Put a raw Brussels sprout on a lollipop, stick it and cover it with chocolate frosting and sprinkles if you want to be the latest parent on the planet. Right? Or, of course, I'm sure there's people out there that put human organs inside theirs. right? Probably the people who are producing the Today Show. That's what they're doing behind closed doors anyway. All right, tricky TV remote. Well, you know what the greatest April Fool's joke ever played is? The one they're playing on us right now with the media. Yeah, it's also very abusive. Anyway, ever had to mediate a family fight over who gets to choose the channel? Thankfully, I haven't. This prank will leave everyone equally confused. Put a piece of black electrical tape over the remote sensor on your TV and watch your family try to change the channel with no luck. Well, probably be the best thing that happened as long as the TV's off. That would actually be interacting between the family. It would probably take them 25 hours to figure out what it is, since people nowadays have the IQ of a beetle, but okay. All right, celebrity photo swap. This prank will test just how observant your family members are the night before April Fool's. Replace all your framed family photos with pictures of your favorite celebrity. Yeah, again, if you have the free time. Why, jeez. If you have the free time for a really bad prank, wait and see how long it takes for your family to realize that your Christmas card photos have been replaced by action shots of Dwayne Johnson, right? Of course, these people won't know the difference because they live in fantasy land and worship false idols, and they already imagine themselves married to these people anyway. So, again, these are lit jokes, right? So, short shoes. When your kids try to put on their shoes before school on Monday, they'll be wondering why their feet have grown several inches. Stuff the toes of your kids' shoes with cotton and wool. Pop goes the bubble wrap. There's only two left, thank goodness. This gag will start off April Fool's Day with a bang. Put a layer of bubble wrap under areas that your family frequently walks on, such as the bath mat, kitchen.
Thank you guys for watching. Love you guys. Have a good day. Bye.